And yeah, if you see, this is the problem we are talking about. It's there in Geeks for Geeks practice also. Key pair. Determine whether or not there exists two elements in A whose sum is exactly K. And here tags are different. Microsoft, Flipkart, Carvalet, Amazon. Yeah, so N square solution is clear to everyone. Can I say that? N square solution is not a big deal for anyone to code. We will not discuss that code. So what is it that we can make better from N square? Better than N square can be what? Two pointer requires sorting. So that will be, so what is the time complexity of sorting? N log N in sorting. Then after sorting, we are doing I and J pointer thing, which is N additionally. So overall it becomes N log N. So N square solution, N log N solution, most of the libraries that we use, if it is C++, the sort function is A plus N. This one line of code with hash include algorithm using namespace std will sort our array. If it is Java, how do we sort it? If it is Python, sort A. People who are Python people here. Yeah, how do we sort in Python? It is A dot sort. Okay. I mean, for these kind of syntaxes, we can search online. Even I am not well versed with Python, but it's just that since I know here more people are there with Python, so we can documentation and all, we can search online. In C sharp, S capital. That's one difference in C sharp and Java. Java will have function name starting with lowercase. C sharp will have capital case.
Array is one of the class, static class.
Okay, so it's similar to Java then. So once we have sorted it, yeah, very valid point. So LeetCode problem is saying the given array, you have to return the indices of that who are at valid. So that is the twist. If you see, they have added. An interviewer also do the same. In interview, they say, I want you to return me those indices. Now you're, this is gone. Sorting is gone. Right? But if indices was not the requirement, if Boolean was the requirement, this approach would have worked. Right? But still, we know it has n log n time complexity. What is better than n log n? N. Okay. Anybody with n solution, let's say sorting is out of question. Okay, one clue. Set is there with three functions, insert, check, and size. And I say all three are big O of one operations. Your search complexity will be reduced. Now can you think of, oh, there's one more parameter I missed. Sum also is required, right? For hash pair sum, array, size of the array, and what sum you are looking for. Can we use set somehow to solve this problem? Okay. Yeah. And one more thing is coming in Java, you can use map. Yeah. Okay. So map or set both are, you can say hashing, hash set, hash map you can use. So this problem can be solved with set and map. So right now I'm keeping map outside. We will have that conversation in our first class. So map, set, sorting, recursion. These are the four topics when the batch starts, the first day we will be discussing. So imagine if array is 1, 3, 7, 20, and if we are searching for a sum of 10, we just want to work out an approach. So somebody said, let's take a look at the first element. It is 1. In the array, remaining array, search if 9 is there. And how we are getting 9 is from sum, we are subtracting current element. And if we search for that in the remaining array, the search complexity will be, we are searching in n minus 1 size array. It will be n minus 1 for the first element. For second, it will be n minus 2. For third, it will be n minus 3. Eventually, it will become n square. So we want to improve this search capability. Search how? however we want to optimize. In set, check is big O operation, whether a value is there in the set or not. Now, how do we use that is a question. Anyone with an approach, imagine set is given to you. Take the first element, 1, subtract from 10, and in the set check if 9 is there or not. Initially, our set will be empty. Do we have anything in the set as of now? No, we just declare a set, it is an empty set. Okay, 9 is not found. So what do we do? We add 1 to the set. So set will get 1 in it. So that later on, if there was 9 somewhere, at least that 9 can find 1 easily. Right? Then 1 is added to the set now. Then we come to 3. For 3, what are we checking in the set? 7 is there or not. In set right now, there is only 1. 7 is not there, so we'll say, okay, 7 is not there. So what do? We add 3. Then we come to 7. 7 will search for 3 in the set. It is there? Found. So answer? We got the answer over here. In this case, true. But in lead code problem, we have to give the indices. So how do we manage that? When we had put 3 here, we are able to check 3. That's where I think you were saying map will help. In map, we can store the value as well as the index of that value. Right? Yeah, we'll have to use map here. Set will not. But anyways, if we have to give Boolean answer, set will suffice and set will help us find that answer. Because in set, this search function is big O of 1 function. Right? And if I have to code this, how will I code? I'll say set of int s. In Java, it will be hash set. Integer hs is equal to new hash set. Okay. Now we say for int i0, I less than n, I plus plus. What is it that I need to check in the set? If s dot find, what do I want to search in the set? S minus a of I. If it is there, this will return s dot n. Don't be worried if you do not know the syntax of set. Right now, this is just syntax which we can master easily. I'll share some notes. And notes has, okay, there was one question that Arjun was asking. He was saying, do I need to go back and refer to the maths book since we are talking about logarithms, summations? So for all that, we have some notes. Whatever math is required, it's not that we require entire math. Whatever little math is required, we have captured that in the form of notes, and that we will share after today's session. So you will have access to it. You just go over the 2-pager document, that's good enough. We don't need, whatever is required, you will have provided from here. You don't need to buy any math book of 10th class, so don't worry. So this is checking, if this returns end, that means it is not available. If it is not equal to end, you can say end is equivalent to saying true or false. So this means it is found. So this means it is found in the set. If it is found, what should we do? If the remaining value is found in the set and Boolean is the answer we are returning, return true, else return false. Correct? No. At one element, we cannot return false. We have to evaluate others also. Right? This would have been wrong. Here, we can return true if we find the other value. If we don't find, let's continue our search. And we also have to insert. If it is not found, imagine, then we were saying s dot insert. We insert AI. That's what we were doing. We said insert the current element if you don't find the difference. And in the end, if we go over this entire thing, return false. Right? So this would have been the approach if Boolean was the answer. But if Boolean was not the answer, if answer is the pair of those indices, then we will have to use map here, and map stores the key and value pair. So you store the difference and its index also, so that you can leverage the index and you can return the value. So for map, we will have extra problems on MentorPick. First, to make you comfortable with map and set syntax, then you can start using them. Right? Right? Now for this problem, what is the time complexity? This solution. We are running a loop. Inside the loop, we are doing find operation and insert operation. Both are order of one operations. So n times this loop is going to run, and we are not breaking the loop. Okay, in best case, we may break early also. Right? If the first two values are the sum, we may break early. But we do not worry about the best case. We worry about the worst case. In worst case, how long will it go? So it will be big O of n. Time wise, it is big O of n. Space wise, in worst case, how many values will we be storing in the set? N minus 1 in worst case, which is again big O of n only. So we have traded off some space, some memory to optimize our n squared solution, n log n solution to big O of n. And now we are aware of three solutions here. For Boolean problem, all these three solutions are valid. Right? With third problem, the only thing is here space also became n. Here, if you would have sorted, the space was 1, here the space was 1, right?